Hi, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at chaparral, the last and fourth of the main plant communities that a hiker is likely to encounter in Southern California along the hiking trails below 4,000 feet above sea level. We're going to pay particular attention to the difference between coastal sage scrub and chaparral. They're both dominated by shrubs rather than full-sized trees, but how do you know which is which? We're going to talk about some of the dominant plants, the main common plants that you're going to encounter, their adaptations, what they look like, as well as some of the, a little bit on the kind of plant and animal life you're going to find as well. So, one thing that's that really stands out immediately is that the shrubs that are found in chaparral are much bigger, taller, fuller than what you're finding in coastal sage scrub. Coastal sage scrub, you can walk through, okay? This, you can't, okay? You'd get all torn up from all the sticks and branches trying to maneuver through this. But yet, it really doesn't, the shrubs don't grow that much taller than your head, okay? This is not a full-size woodland, okay? So that's really some of the key differences, for one thing. But also, the plants here are much more evergreen, are typically more evergreen. So if you compare these black sage and this coastal sage scrub, which is kind of light green, or this California sagebrush and black sage, and you compare that to this sugar bush here, the dark green leaves of this sugar bush here, you could really immediately tell the difference. This is an evergreen shrub. The California sagebrush and the black sage do actually drop their leaves in the long dry summer. These chaparral shrubs, which are larger, more evergreen, typically have deeper roots that can probe a lot of the weathered rock and soil that grow below it. So whereas the plants that dominate the coastal sage scrub are typically have shallow roots and can thrive on clay soils, these kinds of plants like this, as well as this chamise, as you can see here, they typically need a little bit more moisture, so they're going to be found where there's just a little bit more of a moisture source, or where their roots can probe some of the cracks and fractures and joints in the rocks. Okay, so this is also dominated by Toyon, as you can see right here, and scrub oak. This is related to the coast live oak that we saw in the oak woodland in the previous video, but it is a little different. It does not get nearly as tall, okay, but it is an oak tree and it does produce acorns like oak trees typically do. So again, coastal sage scrub is much lower. Most of the plants don't get much above your waist. They tend to be lighter green, kind of a gray green in color, and they smell really good. Chaparral is very, very difficult to walk through. Dominated once again by plants like this chamise, like ceanothus or wild lilac, which should be blooming in the next month or two. It's in February after a nice wet winter, still wet winter. Scrub oak, toyon, and sugar bush. Okay, this is a sugar bush here. So that's a little bit about chaparral. It might take a little bit more time to hike up to, because it's oftentimes found slightly at higher elevations. And also, usually it takes longer to recover after a wildfire. Typically, this gets about as dense as it's going to get about 20 years after a wildfire. In a future video series, we're going to be looking at the stages of wildfire recovery in these ecosystems.